in English, between tolerance and aggression, the harmony of our immune system. So first, as a very simple beginning, so the immune system is carrying out a very difficult and important role. From one side, it protects us from every foreign bodies which attack our bodies. Every pathogens like virus, bacteria, fungi, and started to attack it. And at the same time, from the other side, it recognizes all the components and the particles or the cells which belongs to our body, and it didn't attack it, but it tolerated it. So this seems that it's a happy scenario, but another unhappy scenario can also occur, which is the body or the immune system started to, instead of tolerating its own cells, it started to attack it. And this led to an autoimmune diseases. So the question is now, who carry out this important equation, this very difficult task? So we should think about the T cells, which Professor Schild just talked about it, because they are the really soldiers of our immune systems. And why this has happened, why the T cells started to, instead of tolerating our bodies and organs, started to attack it. So I briefly will tell you, or the story of the T cells, or from where they come. So the T cells is already come from stem cells, and these stem cells is in the bone marrow, and the birth of the T cells come from the stem cells in the bone marrow as immature T cells. They come into the blood, and as immature T cells send the mother the kids to the school. And where is the school? The school found in a very small specialized organ near the heart. It's called thymus. And so what did the young T cells study in the school thymus? So first things, you have to differentiate between what belong to our body and what foreign, which is considered as an enemy. And yes, second thing, keep always tolerance to self. Never ever attack yourself. But finishing a school without examination is impossible, as we all know. And that's why the T cells passes through very two important exams, Staatsexamen 1 und 2. So Staatsexamen 1, in this case, it's called positive selections, which means that just good T cells, which is highly qualified, which can do this task, can just be selected to go to the second exam. And the second exam is called a negative selection, which means that all other T cells which don't show this ability to differentiate between what's enemy and what's friend, what should be attacked and what not attacked, these cells should be immediately destroyed. And then after that, then they go directly to the life, to the blood. So they have then to practice what did they learn in the school, and then see and to differentiate between what's friend and what's an enemy. So summary, so the story looks very nice. After birth, school, I'm lucky if I found a position. So why I'm not a tolerant if I learn this? So I should be a tolerant. But let's see the other side. There's a schoolscapers, and these schoolscapers could really be a problem in our body, because they go to the periphery. So in this case, for example, they go to the countryside and started to destroy their own homes and country and villages. And the problem in our body that if they go to the periphery, they can cause diseases and problems. So for example, if they go to the joints, they cause this rheumatoid arthritis. Or if they go to the darm, sometimes the German word jump, to the small intestine, they cause inflammatory bowel diseases. Or for example, if they go to the face, they cause this systemic lupus erythematosus. And still, for example, in case of diabetes, they go to the islets of Langerhans and destroy them. Or Sejour's disease, go to the kidney, and multiple sclerosis, go to the brain. So there is a lot of these autoimmune diseases, but they all share the same common and the same reason, where the body started to lose its tolerance to self and started to attack itself. And this required immediately an emergency, the selection committee of the Ministry of Education to meet and to see what is the problem. And the first thing to solve a problem that you, one has to accept the fact that there is a problem, not like an ostrich, for example, just dip the head in the sand and know everything is under control. So the first thing, do we have school scapers? And the answer is yes, we have school scapers. Okay, then maybe can we educate these school scapers if they come back so that they don't start to destroy their own country? But this don't happen in our body, because it's just one way. So it's just they go out and they don't come back to the thymus or to the bone marrow. So which means that, yes, we cannot educate these school scapers. But what can we do else? This is a problem. So the other suggestion is, if we didn't educate school scapers, so then we have to catch them. And let's do it as an experiment, okay? So we start to choose the best students, the best pupils in the school, and started to educate them that they start to bring or suppress these school scapers from attacking their own homes. And so they did this experiment, it's like that. So these catchers are called in our body suppressors, and they are very small population in our body, that's because they are highly qualified, and they don't proliferate. So just like German says, Karriere machen. And their missions, they should bring tolerance to the periphery by suppressing these aggressive T cells. And after a certain period of time, they found the result is very, very effective. So now we have a very small, genuine, and effective. And the problem now, if you want to know the value of of being healthy, then you have to ask a sick person. And what we are trying to do is we are trying to understand in our research group how this very small population is doing a very big and very important job. They are preventing an autoimmune disease to happen. And if we started to make an effect, just a small effect in these small populations, this will lead to disease. And we are trying to understand how this occurs. And that's why in real body, if there's just a small defect in these small cells, this means that the last defense is already broken and it comes to an autoimmune disease. So all the drugs in the market is again is the symptoms, again is inflammations, again is the pain, but this is again is the symptoms. We need something untraditional which can treat the problem from the beginning. And this could be the stem cells. So we have to return one step back to the parents, because these parents didn't send the children to the school. And that's why we can give an intensive course to the parents, awareness course, because why stem cells is the future? Because they're giving up kids, and these kids build up the society, because these stem cells can go to and build up every type of cells in our body. And what we can do then is we give an awareness courses, intensive courses to the parents. Please send your kids to the central tolerance school in the thymus.
1 minute to go.
And this is called, and we can do this by gene therapy. So by this reestablishing tolerance, we can isolate the stem cells and then destroy these auto-aggressive T cells by Fukushima. And then by gene therapy, then we can handle the parents to send their kids to the school. And finally, I would like just to give some useful tips, maybe how we could strengthen our immune system. So it's already winter and it's cold, but sport is always very good. And yes, so please always keep fit. And the second thing is always eat 5% from everything and don't eat 100% of just one thing as a rule of thumb. And yes, avoid always the stress. especially in the exams, of course. And finally, for the workaholics, avoid, don't forget to have a sleep. And thank you. I'd like to thank maybe our research group, Helmut Unolite, Loops for the well organizations. And yes, thank you very much.